Hey guys, in this episode, I'm going to show you how I built my FPV cockpit with throttle, control stick, and rudder pedals that can be used for flight sim or bring it to the field to fly an RC airplane. How it works is very simple. I'm just using thread to connect radio transmitter sticks to the control and throttle stick and rudder pedals to transfer the movements. For example, if I push this throttle stick, it will pull the string and also pull the left slider here or my jumper T16 transmitter. I also use rubber band to the slider, so if I move the throttle back, the slider will move down. I had to spare it aileron and elevator control. This is aileron and elevator stick. I only use one axis of movement for aileron only, because if I also use elevator function on the same stick, like on my first try, the movement will be conflicting each other. I move the elevator control to the right slider here, also the same for rudder and throttle. So you will need to have a transmitter that can do this setup, like OpenTX transmitter, or for common transmitter like FlySky FS. I6, you can use other input like this knob right here. I started with this plastic chair and added a lightweight steel post to elevate the radio transmitter, and then make a box for transmitter from PVC foam board and EVA foam, and then make a box to be a base for control stick and rudder pedals. I use 1-inch PVC pipe for the control stick. At first, I use chopsticks like this. All the aileron and elevator strings will be tied up on the end of the bamboo stick, but in the end, I abandon it. And then by using lightweight steel bar, I join the box with the chair. The rudder pedal system is very simple. With the shaft on the middle, you can swing the pedal to the left and right, and the rubber bands will return it to the center again. And this is how the throttle stick looks like, using friction from EVA foam to hold the stick position. One of the reasons I'm making this because my transmitter jumper T16 can also be used as a joystick for flight sim game on PC. So I wanted to control it like a real plane. At first test, I didn't connect the rudder yet. I tested using Aerofly RC simulator game and also Microsoft Flight Simulator. The aileron control was not precise and the elevator was too sensitive, even though I already using 70% of expo. But I think it was a progress because the control was working, just need some tweaking. Finally, I knew why the aileron control was not precise, because at first I used too many ports to guide the thread. So it had too many friction and making the movement was not smooth. The solution is I bypassed all guide ports to minimize the friction. The second test on simulator. The aileron movement was already precise enough, the elevator was better than before, but still a bit jumpy, still need more smoother movement on pilot input. The rudder pedals were also working well. You know, it's very fun using control like a real plane. I love this. I made a special plane for testing this cockpit control. It's twin boom pusher prop configuration plane. I name it Alap Alap. It means hawk in English. It uses small 2212-1400 kV motor with 8-inch propeller, 20M EIC. I use Runcam 2 for FPV and video recording. The VTX power is 600 milliwatt. For the transmitter, I use Jumper T16 with Beta FPV micro transmitter module and micro receiver. Small elevator for anticipate sensitive stick control. Big ailerons for maneuverability, and the dihedral on the wing for stability. This is the time when I test this cockpit control on the field with real RC plane. It took me about 15 minutes to setting up this ground station. I use my old video receiver and connect it to an LCD TV via AV output.
Patah, om, di atas. Masih aman.
This is the first time my plane ever to snap its wing. Never before. I thought I was too fast flying the plane, and it's because the throttle control was not too precise. The wing looked like flexing. My friend said the wing not strong enough, but when I examine it closer when it's about to land, it's the rubber bands that hold the wing were not strong enough. Like this. So it looked like the wing that was flexing. So make sure to use enough rubber bands to hold the wing. Let me explain about the string connections. I use hooks on each strings so it can be portable. The chair, the transmitter post, the box below can be disassembled for transport. I already told you about the throttle, but let me tell it again. When I push the throttle stick forward, it will pull the string that is connected to the left slider here. I use left slider as channel 3. And this rubber band is for bring back the slider down, so when I ease back the throttle, the slider will go down too. All strings have hooks so it can be portable. This aileron stick only has one axis of movement with two strings attached on the opposite direction, all connected to the control stick via between the two chair legs and through both sides of the front chair legs. Both sticks extended by paper roll, also to be portable. The transmitter must be secured, not moving, that's why I have this foam on each sides and on the bottom. I move channel 2 or elevator control to this right slider. You can see here, this is an elastic thread to pull the stick back down again after I ease pulling the stick. Both strings on the sides are for aileron, and the middle one is connected to the elevator or right slider. Now the rudder pedals. This is the shaft. I can swing it to the left and the right. It always returns to center with the help of two rubber bands on both ends. I connect the string here. It has to be loose so the stick on the transmitter can relax on the center. After repairing the plane on the field, I try it again. But this time I fly it with line of sight without FPV. Damn, the elevator is way too sensitive. I took off prematurely and almost crashed from stalling. And this time the elevator was not responding, maybe because the control was not too precise. On the previous flight, rudder was not even used, So this time I switch the elevator with rudder stick and eliminate the rudder control and also remove all the servos for twin rudders on the plane. Damn it, this time the FPV feed is lost due to bad soldering on the VTX power.
5 minutes later.
This time the damage was very bad, so I have to rebuild the fuselage and twin booms. Luckily, I can still use the wing. I found another mistake. Have to watch the aileron string tension, especially when the stick is pulled up. On the previous flight, the tension was quite weak when the stick is pulled up, so the aileron was not responsive. I fly it without FPV again to familiarize the control. The aileron and elevator were already precise, but this time I can reduce the motor power to zero. FPV video feed lost again, but now from my Google power cable. Okay, that's it guys, thanks for watching. If you like this video, consider to subscribe or join membership to support me, and see you in the next episode.